Today, we are getting to business. I'm going to show you exactly how to do these 8 simple SEO hacks that are going to help you really nail EEAT for SEO. Now, if you want to understand the why behind these, why they work, you got to go check out the interview I did with Kyle Roof. I'll put a link to that in the description below, as well as in the pinned comment. But right now, it's time to go do these 8 hacks so you can get EEAT right and you can nail your SEO. Nailing SEO hack number 1. We're gonna make some specific customizations to the footer of the website. We're gonna add a couple of things that are gonna help add legitimacy to your site. I'm gonna do this on a brand new website and I'm going to be using Cadence Theme. This is a free version of the theme and it's gonna allow you to fully customize your footer to make it look awesome like this. Here you can see the footer for this website. What we're adding here is this contact information. Let me show you exactly how I do that. Here in the WordPress dashboard, I click Appearance, Customize, then I'll click Footer. Then here on the bottom, I have all these spots where I can place information. Cool thing here is I can click on any one of these rows. And then here on the left, I can change the number of columns as well as the layout. In the first column, we put the logo. So in the second column is where I'm gonna put that contact information. So here I just select widget number 1. Next, we're gonna go here to copyright. One of the 3 things we wanna do here is ensure that the year for the copyright is up to date. Cadence does this for me. I can put in copyright and then this little year code, that's just gonna keep it always updated with the current year. Here it has site title, and then I'm gonna take out the theme credit. I don't need everybody knowing I'm using Cadence. With that gone, I can hit publish. I can close out of here. Now I'm gonna go to appearance and then widgets, and then here under footer 1, that's the widget we're going to edit. I'm gonna add a block, and it's gonna be a paragraph. I'll type contact us. There are 2 things we wanna add here, an address and a phone number that matches the same locality. So we're gonna add a paragraph block and type in your address, and then in another space, we're gonna go ahead and add a phone number. We can also go ahead and play around with background colors, make it look really pretty. I'm also gonna make this contact us probably into a heading and make it match the menu headings that I have in the other places on the footer. Nailing SEO hack number 2, this is the about page and organization schema. What we're gonna do is create an about page on our website. Here's an example about page from our project charity website, terraintreaders.com. On this page, we're gonna include some information about the organization, the company, the website, and its purpose. But we're also going to add organization schema. There's 2 ways to do this. The first is if you're using a WordPress theme or plugin that has organization schema built in. Our WordPress theme Akabato does. I just check this box to enable organization schema. I choose which page I want it to go on. In this case, it would be that about page, right, that we just talked about. And then I just fill in some of this information. What's the legal name of the organization behind it? Maybe it's the name of the website. What is the URL? Well, it's the URL of this website. And we're just gonna fill out this information and it is all gonna be applied in the code on the back end of that page. The other easy way is to go use this free tool, technicoseo.com. It's a schema generator. I here say that I want to use organization schema. I fill in all the boxes here, have it generate my schema, and over here on the right, it generates this script. I can copy that script. I can go back here to the about page and edit it. And then here at the bottom of the page, I am just going to add an additional block and I want a code block. And right there, I paste the code that I just got and voila, you can see it doesn't look like there's anything there. But if we actually look at the back end code, that script that we just put in there, it's there on the back end of the page. Adding these things is gonna boost the legitimacy of your site, which goes a long way toward nailing SEO. Nailing SEO hack number 3. Add a person page for every single author on your website and use person schema. From the about page on this website, I have a link to each person that's an author on the site where I will have a custom page. This one is currently blank. Now, an easy way that you can add person schema is when I go to edit this page, I'm using Rank Math SEO as an SEO plugin. And so I come over here to the right and click this is schema. And I choose, instead of having this be an article type page, I change this, I'm gonna delete this one and I'm gonna select person. Here I fill in the information about that person, any and all of it that I feel like filling out, and I save it for the post, and voila, I have person schema associated with this page. Now by default for the headline, it's gonna use the SEO title, which is the name of the page, which I happen to name Rick Kessler, so that's gonna work just fine. If I wanna include a local address, I can save my gender, I can say my job title, and I might include my work street address, and I'll leave it at that for now, and I'll save it for this post. Now with Rank Math, there's actually a Rank Math blog I can choose, and it's called Schema by Rank Math. I'm gonna add that here, and I'm gonna go ahead and update this page. Now you can see that by adding that block, it actually took the information from my schema and published it on the live page. When you use schema markup for a page, the best practice for SEO is to make sure that that same information is also present on the page. I may not want it to appear in this format, so I might go ahead and change it, but for now, this is gonna work just fine. Nailing SEO hack number 4. This is actually two small hacks in one. The first is we need to minimize 404 errors on our website. This is when somebody uses a link or types in a URL to a page on your website that doesn't exist. It flags an error, and too many of these errors is a signal to Google, who notices and tracks these things, that there's something going on with your website. So the best thing that we can do is monitor when those errors are happening. My favorite way to monitor these is with a plugin like, again, Rank Math SEO. Here on Rank Math, I can go here to 404 monitor, and it's gonna show me all of the 404 errors taking place, how many times that particular one has happened, as well as when the last time it happened was. Now, a lot of these where there's one hit, right? I'm not that worried about it. It tells me that somebody probably typed in a URL that doesn't exist. And in a site that's actually been live for a while, you're gonna see some that are a lot higher than that. It probably means that a link exists somewhere that points to that URL and multiple people are clicking on it. When that happens, we want to make sure that there's an actual resource for them to go to. So what do we do if those are links that are on our website? Well, we just go to where that link exists and we update it. But what if people are clicking a link on somebody else's website and we have no ability to change that? Well, then we just go to that particular error. We clicked redirect right here and we put in a URL where we want people to actually end up. It's often just a typo in the link or a page that you've updated on your website and changed the URL to. Create the redirect, click add redirection, no more 404 error for that particular URL. The second thing we want to do is minimize broken links. These are links on your site that lead to 404 errors or to pages that just don't exist. The easiest way to deal with this is to actually check for broken links on your website using a tool. Ahrefs has a free tool here. You just type in the domain or URL of a website and it's going to go looking for broken links across that site and give you a full report. Then you just go through and update those links with new ones. Another great way to do it is with this tool, ManageWP. ManageWP is where I have my backup and a whole bunch of other different things. And one of these is called Link Monitor. For something like $1 a month, they will monitor up to 10,000 links on your website and let you know proactively if one of them becomes broken. And then you can fix it almost in real time. Nailing SEO hack number 5. This is again two small hacks that both have to deal with the hosting on your website. First is that we need to minimize 500 errors. These are errors that happen when your website just won't load. For that, we need to make sure that we're using a good host that's fast and that has high uptime. I use ManageWP's uptime monitor on some of my websites. Again, I think it's like 70 cents a month per website. And this shows me that in the last 24 hours, my site's been up 100% and that the overall uptime for this website is 99.92%. That's because I have an awesome host. I use Cloudways. Every now and then it goes down, but it's always very brief, which is why my uptime is so high. If your uptime is not where you'd like it to be, it might be time for you to go ahead and upgrade hosting to something a little bit better. Now, the next thing has just become a must-have for SEO, and it's very easy to do, and it's getting an SSL certificate. With an SSL, essentially, that all the interactions that a user has with your website become encrypted. So if somebody else is monitoring them somehow, they can't decrypt what actually happened, and your user's information and behavior is kept encrypted. Hosting companies will just take care of this for you. If you don't know what I'm talking about, just go ask them in support, file a ticket. These days, SSL certificates are free and every host is making it easy for you to install them. You can install it yourself here on Cloudways. I'm just here under my example website and I just click SSL certificate. I put in an email address to associate with it and the domain name for it and click install certificate. They even have an option to make it so that it automatically renews and I just never have to worry about it again. For your web host, you can just contact their support and they'll probably just take care of it in a matter of minutes and you'll have your SSL certificate, one and done, easy peasy. Both of these are just really simple one-time hacks, but without them, good luck nailing SEO. Nailing SEO hack number 6, we need to have a sitemap. You should submit an XML sitemap to Google Search Console. We'll talk about Google Search Console another time. But you should also have an HTML sitemap that's actually on your website, so it's really easy for Google to crawl the whole site. One and done. For this, I keep it easy and I just use Rank Math. Just make sure that you have sitemap turned on. And then under the sitemap settings, I can grab the URL for the sitemap that it's automatically generating and updating every time I add new content to the site. Grab this URL, that's what we're gonna give to Google Search Console. But right here, I can click HTML sitemap and turn that on. Then I can either use the short code right here to embed that sitemap on any page I want on my website, or I can click page and I can just choose a page, a blank page on my website, create a blank one, and just select that and it will place that HTML sitemap for you. Then what I do is I actually put a link to the HTML sitemap in the footer of my website. And voila, we're done with the sitemap. Having both the XML and the HTML sitemap further sets you up for nailing SEO. Nailing SEO hack number 7, set up Google Analytics. Knowing how your content is doing further enables you to be able to perform extremely well in search. So for that, we go here to analytics.google.com, click start measuring, make a name for your account, click next, set up your property. The property is the website. And then put in a little bit of information about your business. If it's just you, that's fine. And go ahead and check the boxes for the things that you're using Google Analytics for and click create. Accept their terms of service. Now your Google Analytics account is set up and we're just gonna have to go put a Google Analytics tag over on our website. I have a full video showing the full walkthrough of setting up a website, including this step that you should make sure you go check out if you're not sure how to do this. Nailing SEO hack number 8, we are gonna connect Google Search Console. Google Analytics is awesome, but Google Search Console, it tells us not only how people are interacting with our site, but it tells us exactly how our site is showing up in search, which search phrases are being used that surface our content, and how often they're getting clicked. It's amazing information that can help us refine our content to do far better in search. So we just go here to the Google Search Console page, put in the domain name of our website, and click continue. Now, you can use the URL prefix method. Don't do that, use the domain method. Essentially what this is doing is creating Google Search Console in a way that takes into account HTTP, HTTPS, the www version of your URL, and the non-www version of your URL. So we're just gonna do this one. Now, it doesn't know for sure that I own this domain name, so what do? I need to start verifying it. Now, it wants to check via DNS records. I like to do it this way, but if you can't do it this way, there are other options, but this way's the best. So it knows that I have it registered through Cloudflare. I go ahead and start verification. It's just gonna ask me to log into my Cloudflare account, and when I do, it's gonna see, oh look, this domain name is there in your account, and voila, it's gonna verify. This used to be a more complicated step. Google just made this super easy for us. Google Search Console really is a gold mine of information. As soon as you start having some people interacting with your content, that information is going to go so far toward helping you with nailing SEO. Now, these hacks are all actually pretty simple to do, and together they add up to do a lot for us from an SEO standpoint. This is kind of a checklist. I want you to check as many of the boxes as you can, even if you can't do all of them right now. Now, for a little bit more in-depth discussion on what these things are actually doing for us, make sure that you check out this video here where I interviewed Kyle Roof and where he explains exactly what this does to help us with, well, you guessed it, nailing SEO.